October 27th is observed as World Audio and Visual Heritage Day, and the preservation officer at the National Archives of St. Lucia says it is important to preserve AV material. He says more has to be done to raise awareness of the significance of AV documents and to draw attention to the need to safeguard them for future generations.
National Archives exists to collect, preserve, and make accessible information of historical importance to the wider nation. We have different mediums we preserve at the National Archives, including videotapes, vinyl tapes, reel-to-reel tapes, and microfilm. Well, at National Archives, what we try to do is to create that atmospheric condition that is conducive to the longevity of those materials. Because at the moment, we do not have what you call a conservation lab where we could do any restoration work because of the lack of finance we need in order to institute that lab. However, we try our best to maintain the atmospheric condition that will ensure the longevity of the materials.
Mr. Freeman says it is extremely important that these records are preserved as they capture the historical patrimony of the nation.
Without those records, perhaps persons coming in later would not know what St. Lucia was, let's say, 50, 20, 30 years ago. So it is important that we preserve those records in order to make it accessible to persons coming at a later date.
Radio St. Lucia's general manager also spoke on the matter of preserving AV records. The station has a huge collection of historical AV material in its archives, which it has been attempting to digitize and preserve, but he says the process is moving at a snail's pace.
It still has thousands of hours of audio, ranging from cultural activities to independence and the like. We have a current member of our team assigned to do our archiving. He has done quite a lot thus far. About a couple thousand hours of audio has been archived digitally. However, we still have tens and tens of thousands to be digitized. The challenges would just be manpower. We have the system in place. We have the reel-to-reel recorder to facilitate the process. However, we don't have the manpower that is needed to do it at the pace that which we'd like. So currently our tapes are housed in a physical structure, which we don't want it to be there because, you know, you have the weather conditions, hurricanes can come and wipe all that away. So we are hoping probably in the next couple of months to get an intern on board, or at least some part-time workers, dedicated. Persons like Harold George has written to us with proposals for that job. So he's been under consideration, and hopefully in the near future we could have that done.
For the DBS News World, I am Alex Bousquet.